Well, the altar boy emeritus that I am is tempted to quote from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 12, verse 48. The good book tells us, from everyone who has been given much, much more will be demanded. And from the one who has been entrusted with much, much more will be asked. End of quote. This week, two governors have with impunity snubbed Senate County Public Accounts and Investments Committee sittings in Kitui County, where senators are staging the second edition of the Senate Mashinani. The reasons, or rather excuses, advanced by Machakos Governor Alfred Mutua and his Makueni counterpart Kivutha Kibwana are not only laughable, but laced with huge amounts of impunity. Mutua, since 2013, has been slapped with qualified opinion from the Auditor General. In auditing terms, a qualified opinion is a written statement by a certified public accountant in an audit report stating that the financial statements of a client are fairly presented except for a specified issue. The issue typically relates to a limitation on the scope of the audit so that the auditor was unable to obtain sufficient evidence to verify various aspects of the transactions and reports being audited. Qualified opinions may also be issued if there is lack of conformity with accounting procedures, inadequate disclosure, uncertainties in estimates, or the statement of cash flows has been omitted. In essence, an organization that is being audited tries to avoid a qualified opinion since it casts doubt on the financial statements of that entity. End of quote. What is my point? In the last 3 months, governors and senators have forged a united front in pushing for increased allocation to county governments in the 2019-2020 financial year. Their united position being that the 310 billion shillings initially proposed by the National Treasury and the National Assembly was not only inadequate, but was a slap on the face of devolution. The pressure yielded a 6.5 billion shillings increase, meaning devolved units will receive 316.5 billion shillings in shareable revenue and another 62 billion shillings in conditional grants. But it seems that this is where the relationship between governors and senators end. Makueni Senator Mutula Kilonzo Jr. aptly captured it when he said today, the lavidavi we'd had with governors ended when the monies hit their accounts. End of quote. His Kitui counterpart Enoch Wambua had this to say, I'm ashamed to be associated with the governors of Kitui, Machakos and Makueni. They are acting like they are above the law, yet they are nowhere being above the law. End of quote. Accountability in use of public resources is not an option. It is a principal expectation for all state and public officers. Governors cannot ask for more resources and frown when asked to account. They cannot stage walks to the Supreme Court demanding advisory opinions from the country's top judges on resource allocation, but sulk when challenged to show what they did with previous allocations. The immediate former Auditor General Edward Owoko in his exit report indicated that at least 1 trillion shillings across both levels of government cannot be properly accounted for every financial year. So in the last 8 years he was in office, it means that at least 8 trillion shillings could not be accounted for. 8 trillion shillings is enough to clear all our public debt and remain with enough change to run the country's budget for a whole year. Certainly, something must give. Governors must be accountable, and they are not doing anyone a favor. That's my punchline.